In this video, we continue on a series of videos looking at steel conduit. In previous videos, we've looked at saddles, boxes, and some of those rarer boxes. And in the last video, towards the end of it, you started building the stocks and dies, which links in nicely, doesn't it, what we're doing today?
Yeah, we're going to be cutting and threading now.
So we're going to thread a piece of steel conduit. Now, if I've got a length of steel conduit maybe from the van or the stores at college, how long is it likely to be?
It'll be 3 metres.
It will be 3 metres in length, and that's really important because in the old days, it used to be 3.75 metres, and that was a little bit awkward when you think about the electrician and his van, isn't it?
Yeah, so now we've got the pipe tubes on top of the van, so they're 3 metres, so it fits in there nice.
Okay, so we're going to cut, we're going to thread it, and we're going to thread it as if we're simulating, first of all, putting a coupler and therefore a bush on,
yep.
And then we're going to go on and do a spouted box. Do you want to set up your conduit stocks and dies against
yep.
for me?
Okay, so we've got our stocks. I'm going to put the handles in first, then you just screw in.
What I always used to say, that actually with the handles on, that was the stocks, but you're right, that's a stock and the handles in place. Yep. We're going to be threading 20mm, so we're going to need...
We've got our 20mm die, we've got 25 here, we're only going to be using 20mm now. So, unscrew the nuts first, so we can drop the guide in.
And the guide again is for 20mm conduit?
That's right, yeah.
So we pop our guide in. The actual die itself is handed, isn't it?
That's right, yeah. So when we drop our die in, we need to make sure it's sat like that so the nuts can clamp down on it.
And how tight are you going to do those nuts?
Just finger tight, no more.
So I think often apprentices tend to wrench them really tight, don't they? And it only needs to be finger tight.
Snapping them, yeah.
So that's ready to cut a thread onto our conduit. Now, a length of conduit, which you said would be 3 metres, has threads on both ends, doesn't it?
Shall
we have a look at a threaded conduit?
Yep.
So this is how it comes. One coupler, one end, and a thread. And we're going to practice putting a thread on here.
So we've got a thread about half the length of a coupler.
Right.
So if we could see that from the outside, you can see we're just short of a coupler there, which is about right. We don't want them touching each other.
So common method of connecting, say, a conduit to a socket or switch, metal clad obviously, is to use a coupler, and what we've got there is a male bush, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we're going to simulate doing the thread for that, and we're also going to put it into a spouted box, which we've got over here.
Yeah.
So we've got a spouted box as well. So that just simply needs the conduit threading, doesn't it, in
yeah.
order to go into a spouted box. So we'll show both of those. If you want to pop your conduit in, we're going to make a cut in it first, aren't we?
Yeah, that's right.
So just remind me what the jaws of this vise is.
So it's a round jaw clamp.
Okay, so why do we need a round jaw vise on our conduit bending machine?
To make sure that we don't crush or flatten this conduit at all.
Okay, so that's there. Now we've got our hacksaw. Now it's important we get the blade in correctly and the right number of teeth on our hacksaw blade.
Yep.
So you've got a new one there to insert. Can you first of all show me which way round it needs to go?
Yep, so we're going to have the arrow pointing away from us.
Okay, so there's a little arrow on the end there, and it's important, isn't it, when you're training to make sure that goes on correctly.
Yep.
The number of TPI, or teeth per inch, is really important as well. We said, what would be the minimum number of TPI we'd need?
We want a minimum of 24 teeth per inch.
Okay.
So it's 32, as you can see there.
And so what's the thinking behind having lots of teeth when cutting metal?
Yep, so that's better at cutting harder materials.
So if I think about cutting wood, I've got few teeth that are very big in order to cut wood, but I'm actually cutting something really hard. So as I'm using a hard material, I need lots of teeth, but they're fine teeth, aren't they?
That's right, yeah.
I see that that is a bimetal blade. We'd rather it be a high-speed steel one. So again, if you're getting a hacksaw blade and you get a high-speed steel one, that would be better for me. So we're just going to make a cut somewhere on our conduit in order that we can start the threading process. So we're going to end up cutting the thread off that's on it. But as I'm looking at that conduit bending machine, I can see it's set at a bit of an angle there, Jake.
Yep. So when we're cutting, we don't want to be cutting with our hacksaw straight. We need to make sure we're on the same slight angle as the conduit is.
So you're going to slightly roll that over to the side, yeah?
That's right, yeah. I'm going to start off cutting now. I'm going to start off really short strokes just to get going. And then it's going to be large strokes using the full blade.
Doesn't matter which end we look at. So let's have a look at the short one in your hand. So if you want to lift that up to the camera so I can just see how square that end is. So we're gonna just make sure that this end is square before we actually thread it. So we're gonna need to use a file in order to do that. So we're bringing our file. So the end needs to be square.
There we go, I think I'm happy with that, guys.
Okay, so we're nice and square on that end before starting. Now, if this wasn't a finished end, always you say, my students, don't file it until you know it's exactly the right length. But yeah, we're just putting a thread on here. So here's a question for you. Would you ream it at this stage?
No, not at this stage. That's the last thing we'll do once we've threaded it.
So we're going to cut a thread onto the end here. Now, lots of people do it in slightly different ways. Do you put any of the cutting compound on at this stage?
No, not at this stage.
Okay, so you're going to go in dry with your stocks and dies, yeah? Okay, let's do that next then. So ready to put a thread on them?
Yep. So you'll notice I've got my foot, Gary, on the bottom of the conduit bender, stopping that from moving forward. Applying forward pressure as I'm doing these first turns, just till it bites. So we're on now.
Yeah, you can hear that sound. So if you pulled that back, that wouldn't come off, would it? Ah, no, so that thread's cut. So what's the next process?
So I'm gonna take this back off, I'm gonna apply some lubricant, and then start threading.
So add the cutting compound to the end. I'll have a look at your thread while you're getting the cutting compound. It's nice. So yep, there's a nice thread started there. This should make it easier to thread it.
Yep, so I've just got an old hacksaw blade. Can use a brush, bit of PVC lid, chunking lid, anything, whatever you've got. If you've got nothing, just slightly dip it in.
So cutting compound's on. Now there's another part of part of the technique now, is that you're going to do a few rotations forward, is that right?
That's right, yep. And then I'm going to go back one, just to clear all the swarf out.
And we might see that fall out, won't we? So as you're going forward, what, about three or four turns? Ah, there it goes. Yeah, I see it drop out. Yeah. So that swarf there, if it was left in, would create a bad thread?
Yep. So no need to apply any forward pressure now.
Yeah, we saw that swarf coming out. And how many threads are you going to have hanging out the back of the actual die?
So I want about two threads poking out.
So we're not quite there yet.
Yep, there we go.
So you think having two threads out there, it's going to be possibly half the length thereabouts of a coupler?
Thereabouts, yep.
Okay, let's give that a go then. So before we introduce the coupler, we're going to do what to the end of the conduit?
So we're going to ream it.
And what's the thinking about reaming the end for?
Yep, so we don't have any sharp edges on the inside. We don't want to damage cables as we're drawing in.
So those cables are single insulated PVCs, aren't they?
Yeah.
So have a look on the end there.
So, got a conduit reamer. If we don't have one of those, we can use a round file.
Right,
okay. And we'll use the reamer.
Ah, we can see, yeah, we can see that edge now is a lot shinier where obviously it is now smooth.
Yep.
So you can use your cloth just to remove the cutting compound.
Remove the excess compound, yep.
Are we going to put a coupler on this one first, then we'll do a spouted box afterwards?
Yep. I'll just tighten that up with some grips. There we go, no need to over tighten, go mad on that. That's nice and tight.
And the thinking is then that would probably go into a metal clad socket or switch and be connected via a male bush?
Yep.
So sandwiching that between the socket box and the bush.
Like so, yeah.
And again, we'll show how they're tightened up in a different video. If we were to put it onto a spouted box, so that coupler comes off and we've threaded it for a spouted box, you want to show me what that would look like? So off comes our 20mm coupler. Which box have you gone for?
So I've gone for the four-way or the intersection box.
Okay, we picked that up in a different video. Yeah, that's called an intersection box. I called it a four-way box as well. So if this was in situ, you'd actually have to get it in the correct rotation, wouldn't you?
That's
so
right,
it would lay in the right place. So sometimes you have to take off and add a part of a thread on, don't you? So if we just loosen it off out the vise and we'll just spin it around, I'll look inside there. And we're probably gonna have about two threads showing.
Yep, we should have, yep.
So when I look in there, yeah, see two threads. You don't wanna go all the way in because obviously it can roll the edge and that can feel like a sharp edge. So in order to connect into a spouted box, no coupler needed this time, we just threaded the conduit and screwed it straight in.
That's it.
So there we go, we've seen how to thread conduit in order to facilitate either a coupler or a spouted box. Where do you want to take us next?
So we'll look at bending conduit next. We'll start with a 90 degree bend.
So continuation of this series of videos, we'll start looking at bending it. We'll also do sets. We'll do swan nets or bubble sets as well. If there's anything you want to see in this series, please leave the comments below and Jake will try and get back to as many as he can.